Acting Chair, Deputy Chair. Acting Chair. President. All right. I'm befuddled. I will be brief. This bill makes several minor changes to several different pieces of legislation. Among them is a set of changes to the Human Rights Charter. The government wants to replace him or her with they and that person, presumably so that transgender and non-binary people can now have their rights equally not protected by the Charter. It is a change that's meant to be symbolic of the struggle against oppression. But the real symbolism here is that in Victoria, our human rights can be amended or ignored at will. The Victorian Charter has proved to be just words on paper, providing no protections to Victorians' fundamental rights. This government has treated the Charter with the same contempt as it has treated ordinary Victorians. A Charter of Human Rights is an act of Parliament, and it can be undone by the same Parliament, as we've seen only too well over the last 2 years. Thomas Paine recognised this in his The Rights of Man over two centuries ago, but Victoria is yet to figure this out. Now, I'd be willing to compromise and retitle the work The Rights of Persons, if that's what it would take to get this government to read it. There is a role for symbolism. I'm not opposed to language changes to recognise diversity, but the rights of Victorians are not endangered by insensitive use of pronouns in obscure legislation. It's well past time that the rights of all Victorians, with all pronouns, were recognised in a real Bill of Rights, a Bill of Rights that properly restricts government power.